itself. They serve over 1,000 children, and on an average, they have about 330 children per day coming in for after-school programs. And at the facility, they provide meals and snacks. You see, it's over 20,000 meals a year they're providing to children free of cost. They have a dance program, they have a robotics team, they have a music room, they have a gymnasium for gymnastics, a dance facility, and even a workout facility that was pretty cool. So they have an amazing facility. But the one area that we decided to focus on was outside of the city, out towards Elwood City, they actually have a camp. And they're looking to get children, especially inner city children, out into nature and into this camp. And so that's where we focused our attention. So we're going to show you about a minute and a half of a video for you to understand a little bit more about Sarah Heinz House, and then we'll turn it over and tell you about the camp and what our project was.
So Stacy mentioned at our very first meeting with the leadership team of the Sarah Heinz House, we sat down and we really talked through with them what they were looking to accomplish and how it fit in with the nexus of children and the environment. And we toured the facility, she said, wonderful facility. But what we found out was interesting. The Sarah Heinz House is actually funded as a beneficiary of Sarah Heinz's will, funded through the foundation. And it used to be 100% of their funding came from the foundation. However, being the way the economy is lately, that funding has been cut just about in half. So as a result, they have to focus efforts on fundraising now. So what we learned was they really didn't have the time and resources available to effectively promote the camp, which has been underutilized. And again, they serve mainly city-based youth. So for us, it was a no-brainer to say, okay, hey, how can we affect the Sarah Heinz House, keeping it, again, the mission of the nexus of children's environment? As you saw from the video and the pictures that you see, I think the benefits of children being exposed to nature and the environment are really too numerous to mention. One of the other benefits we found, too, was you're bringing together kids of different backgrounds and different districts and different neighborhoods. So they, in turn, tend to develop relationships as well, much as we've developed throughout the time spent together. So you tend to view each other differently once you spend some time actually in a situation like this with folks. So we decided that we would go ahead and we would create a promotional video that they could use to go ahead and promote, again, use of the camp and more youth attending that camp since it is underutilized. And you'll hear as we go through the presentation how we went about deciding the video and what we've done. We also decided that, hey, this is great that it's for the youth of the city, but the benefits don't stop at the city borders. So how can we really impact the most number of children possible? We decided that most of us, obviously, living in the suburbs, we're parts of organizations, youth sports organizations, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, dealing with the school districts that we live in. So we decided that we would also use this as a way to push this out to the very various organizations that we're involved with, thereby accomplishing two things. One, hopefully, you know, getting membership up and attending the camp, but also opening up the whole world of children who maybe had not had that experience before. And lastly, what we want to do is arrange for a feature story on KKA TV, John McIntyre's contacts over KKA. We've all seen that the media is pretty quick to cover negative stories on children today and on youth. But what we haven't seen really is a rush to cover the positive. And as you may have seen in the video, Sarah Heinz is part of the youth of the Boys and Girls Clubs of America, obviously saw thousands of children throughout the country. And last year, the current National Youth of the Year is Nick Foley, who was from the Sarah Heinz House. Information was sent out of the three television stations offline covered that event. You know, here's something that's very positive happening right in our own backyard. So as a result, we wanted to use that not only again to promote the camp, but to promote the work that Sarah Heinz House is doing today.
All right, so what you might be asking, what is the camp about? What is this a weekly thing? Is this a day camp? How does it work? Well, actually, it's an 11-day experience for some children. Some children go for a week, but it's outdoor adventure. So, you know, we went to the camp in the middle of winter to visit it. And so, you know, those of us who, again, that kind of have business, you know, travel type of experiences as of late, went to this camp and said, oh my gosh, this is rustic, right? And I think, you know, we were a little skeptical at first about, can we really promote this camp, and can we promote the idea of youth from the city as well as the suburbs going to this camp when it is so rustic? But as we learned more, we learned that it was more about the activities and the experiences there than the actual fact that there aren't cabins. There are, you know, platform tents, and the kids are out in the tents, they're out experiencing nature as it is, and they love it, and they experience all of the activities of fishing, ropes course, which I refuse to go on the ropes course, and build all of the relationships and friendships that that come with a summer camp experience.
One of the greatest things to learn about this camp was the longevity that they've had in the community and the success that they've had actually in running camps for boys and for girls separately. So with 80 years of tradition, the camp serves as a focal point, connecting the city-based youth with nature. As Tracy said, as rustic, they have a lot of great resources there for water, sports, and for swimming, canoeing, and things like that as well. But in addition, the character and leadership building experiences is impressive, teaming and conflict resolution, and exciting and affordable summer camp choice. When we had gotten there, there wasn't actually any housing situated, so it was very rustic in the fact that it didn't look livable as well. But it's impressive the short period of time that it takes for the staff to get the camp up and running, and the dedication of those volunteers as well.
Well, our first step as we walked through this project was to take a visit. I think the takeaway for all of us was exactly that. It was very rustic. It certainly wasn't the Fairmont. So. But I think the takeaway we got from it was it wasn't really about the place. It was about Sarah Heinz House. It was about their staff. It was about camp counselors, the camp director, the campers from the past had become some camp counselors. There's a real unity, there's a real commitment to the camp, and it was really, their focus was introducing nature, the environment, to
first thing he wanted to do was to really promote this. So there's two steps. One is, as you heard, we're creating the video, and we're going to push that out to organizations. Secondly, KDKA has agreed to do a feature story. I want to thank one of the alumni of Leadership Pittsburgh, Ann Lineberger, who is a good friend of mine, who's agreed to do that. So we feel that those two things will help us meet that objective.
Now, specifically about the project, we've engaged, and thanks to Jen and some others at Help for Sure. Initially, our Super Bowl champion was going to be slightly different. We didn't know his name. He was just described as the long-haired Samoan guy. I won't tell you which group member came up with that one. But. So, for a celebrity message, we have Super Bowl champion Chris Hogue. We have Miss PA Teen USA Julie Belichick. Interestingly, her dad is a Leadership Pittsburgh graduate.
And he's on the board.
And he was our host at Westinghouse, Joe Belichick. And then we have Sharon Vasquez with the Pittsburgh Passion. So you can see we're covering males, females. So our plan is to film each of these people individually and then put together a nice conglomerated video and push them out through multiple channels. Again, thanks to John, we do have arrangement with KDK to do a feature story. We're going to line up as many media outlets as we can. We think it's interesting that we can push this out through the local sports teams. Also, maybe with your help, we can forward this to everybody and we can post it on your Facebook page. That would give us an awful lot of exposure. Now, I think it's an interesting way to get thousands of looks at our video because at the end of the day, we're trying to draw another 40, 50 kids, which would be a significant help to the Sarah Heinz House. So again, hopefully you guys will help us out. And I think just specifically about sports, scouting, and the arts organizations, I know locally, just in Cranberry Township, we have almost 2,000 kids that participate in soccer. And I'll guarantee you none of them know about the Sarah Heinz House. So.
5 minutes questions.
Oh, I'm sorry, just no.